Hello friends, today's our topic of discussion is spinal cord. So spinal cord, in previous video we had seen the central nervous system. Central nervous system is basically divided into two parts, the brain and the spinal cord. And our today's topic is spinal cord. So spinal cord is nothing but it is a lower part of central nervous system. So it is a lower part of central nervous system. The upper part of central nervous system is brain. So it is a lower part of central nervous system. It is responsible for provide contact between the brain and the peripheral end organ. Means the contact between brain and the peripheral end organ is provided with the help of spinal cord. So it is a very important medium to connect the brain with the peripheral end organ. Now we will see from where it is extended, extension of the spinal cord. This spinal cord, it is extended, actually it occupies the upper two-thirds of the vertebral column. Whole of the vertebral column, its upper two-thirds is occupied by this spinal cord. So it occupies upper two-thirds of the vertebral column and it extends from the upper border of atlas vertebra. This atlas vertebra is the cervical first vertebra, or it extends from the foramen magnum, because foramen magnum and the upper border of atlas vertebra lie at the same level. So it extends from the upper border of atlas vertebra to the lower border of vertebra L1 or upper border of vertebra L2. Means it extends from the upper border of atlas up to the lower border of lumbar first vertebra or the upper border of lumbar second vertebra. Because we had seen in the previous video of CSF, the lumbar puncture is done in the space between L3 and L4 or L4 and L5. Because the spinal cord can extend up to the vertebra lumbar first, up to the lower border of first lumbar vertebra or upper border of lumbar second vertebra. So that's why the lumbar puncture is done in between the L3 and L4 or L4 and L5. So this is about the extension of the spinal cord. Now we will see the length. The spinal cord is having length about 45 cm. It is having length about 45 cm. Now how many spinal nerves lies? There are total 31 pair of spinal nerves lies, in which C8 means cervical R8, which is lies in the neck, and thoracic are 12, lumbar are 5, sacral are 5, and coccyx have 1. So all these unite to form the 31 pair of spinal nerves. So total number of spinal nerves lies in the body, they are 31. They are the cervical 8, thoracic 12, lumbar 5, sacral 5, and coccyx 1. Now we will see the shape of the spinal cord, how it is look like. So in case of adult spine, it view like a S shape. If you are taking from side view of the spinal cord, it is view like S shape in case of adults. Now we will see the internal structure of the spinal cord. This internal structure is to be seen after taking the transverse section. This is the view of transverse section of the spinal cord. This is the anterior part and that is the posterior part. Anterior part is also called as ventral part. Posterior part is also called as dorsal part. So this is the transverse section of the spinal cord, and we are seeing the internal structure of the transverse section by the help of transverse section of the spinal cord. So in the transverse section of the spinal cord, this central part, this is a S-shaped part. See, this part is S-shaped and this is to be called as a gray matter. So in the transverse section of the spinal cord, the inner S-shape is called as gray matter, while the outer part is called as white matter. So there are two parts lies in the transverse section. The inner S-shape is the gray matter. This gray matter, it is S-shaped and it is having a anterior gray column. So this is the anterior gray column or ventral gray column. Anterior is also called as ventral. The synonym with anterior is ventral. So anterior gray column or ventral gray column. So this is the anterior gray column or ventral gray column. This one is the anterior gray column. Now the second part of the gray matter is the posterior gray column or posterior horn. Anterior gray column or also called as anterior horn. Posterior gray column also called as posterior horn. So this is the posterior. See, this is the dorsal gray column. Dorsal is also called as posterior. The synonym of dorsal is posterior. So the dorsal gray column or the posterior gray column, it is also called as posterior horn. And in some part there is a lateral gray column also present, but not always, but in the some part of the spinal cord there is a lateral gray column is present. And these both gray column, right and left gray column, they are connected with the help of this gray commissure. So this is the central part, and this right and left half of the gray matter, it is connected with the help of gray commissure, and it is traversed by the central canal. We have seen the central canal, the continuation of the cavity of the fourth ventricle is called as central canal. So central canal is passes from the center, that's why the name is central canal. So this gray commissure is traversed by the central canal. This is about the gray matter. Now the outer part is called as white matter, which is divided into the right and the left half, two half. This outer part, that is the white matter, which is divided into two half. Anteriorly, it is divided with the help of anterior median fissure. Anterior means in front, median means in midline, and fissure means a fissure. So the fissure which separate the right and left white column is called as anterior median fissure. So anteriorly it is separated with the help of anterior median fissure, while as posteriorly it is separated with the help of posterior median septum. This is septum which is called as posterior median septum. Septum is a partition. The partition which separates it from posterior aspect. That's why it is called as posterior median septum, because it lies in the midline. So posteriorly the white matter is separated into right and left half with the help of posterior median septum. Anteriorly it is separated from right to left, right and left, with the help of anterior median fissure. Now we will see this each half, right and left half, they are divided into anterior white column or anterior funiculus. See, this is the anterior funiculus. This part is anterior funiculus. It is also called as the anterior white column. So the white matter which lies anteriorly, also called as the anterior white column or anterior funiculus. The next one is the lateral white column or lateral funiculus. See this part, this which lies on the either side, this is the lateral funiculus or lateral white column. So lateral white column is also called as lateral funiculus. And the last, the posterior one, the posterior white column or the posterior funiculus. See, this is the posterior funiculus. So posterior white column is also called as posterior funiculus. So the white matter on the two half, they are divided, each half is divided into the anterior white column. So this is the anterior white column or anterior funiculus. This is the lateral white column or lateral funiculus. And this is the posterior white column or posterior funiculus. So these are the structure which is seen in the transverse section of the spinal cord. This spinal cord that provide attachment to the spinal nerve, as I have told you, there are 31 pairs of the spinal nerves. So this spinal cord that provides attachment to the spinal nerves, and the spinal nerves, they arise in the two roots, anterior root or ventral root, or posterior root or dorsal root. So there are two roots in which the spinal nerves arise. One number is the anterior or the ventral root. Second number is the dorsal or the posterior root. Now we will see the applied part of this spinal cord. So poliomyelitis, this poliomyelitis, it is a very important disorder. Actually it is a viral disease. It is a viral disease which involves the anterior horn cell. So it involves the anterior horn cell and causes the flaccid paralysis of the affected segment. So there is a flaccid paralysis of the affected segment occurs due to the poliomyelitis. So poliomyelitis, it is a viral disease which involves the anterior horn cell, and that will cause the flaccid paralysis of the affected segment of the body. Now the second applied anatomy, that is a syringomyelia. This syringomyelia, here what happens, there is a dilatation of central canal. As I had told you, the gray matter in the center, they are traversed with the help of this central canal. So here there is a dilatation of the central canal occurs, and that will cause the bilateral loss of pain and temperature in the affected region. So the dilatation of the central canal and that will cause the bilateral loss of pain and temperature in the affected region, that is to be called as syringomyelia. So this is all about the spinal cord. Thank you very much.